Hi guys, this is Bhaskar Berry. Welcome to my YouTube channel. And in the previous video, we have seen about Kafka basics overview. And in this video, I'm going to explain you about some core concepts. So these are some of the terms which we'll be using whenever we are dealing with Apache Kafka, or when you're writing any applications, or whenever you're listening any videos. You often come across these terms. So I just wanted to give the overview, or in a simple terms, in each term what it does mean. So let's start with that. When I say producers, so these are they are nothing but it's an application that sends the data or a message, or we can say a record also, to the Kafka cluster basically. Whatever data we need to send, that producer application will be creating the data, so that we send the data in the form of a message or an array of bytes to the Kafka cluster. So that's a producer. When you come to consumer is also an application where it receives the data. Producer sends the data, consumer receives the data. So how it does is it does through the Apache Kafka broker here. The broker will be handling that message which has been sent by the producer will be stored into the broker, and the subscriber will receive the data from the broker. Okay, so broker it acts as a middle agent between the producers and consumers. Okay, and when you say cluster is nothing but it's a group of brokers. It contains multiple brokers in the distributed systems. Okay, and the topic. Topic is just an arbitrary name given to a data set, similar to the table name, which if we assume it is in SQL, whatever the table names we are given, like SQL, no, the similar kind of names would be given as a topic name. So this one, in the topic, we will be providing various partitions, offset numbers, and consumer groups. So those parameters will be provided in this topic. So I'll explain, I'll show you the practicals and show you how these topics has been created, and what are the partitions we will be giving, and what are the replication factors we'll be giving there. So those terms I'll explain there. So when I say partition, we need to specify the partition during the decision whenever we are creating a topic. So what is this partition? Partition is nothing but it's the smallest unit that sits in a single machine or in a single broker. It contains a small unit of data to process that. Since in the real time, what we have a huge files or a huge data, we can't fit it in one single node or a single broker there. So what we do, we partition the data into smaller chunks, and smaller chunks will be stored into single partition. Okay, that's for the partition here. And offset, this offset is nothing but it's a unique sequence ID of a message in the partition. This will be assigned by the broker itself, and these are immutable, so we can't change once they have assigned it. And for each partition, they generally starts with index 0. So partition 1 will start with 0, 1, 2, 3, and partition 2 will start with again with 0, 1, 2, 3. So why this offset is useful is, like, if you want to know the exact location of any message or any record in these Kafka topics, what we need is we need three things. One is topic name, partition, and the offset number. Topic name, partition, offset number. In which from which topic, in which partition it is located, and what is the offset of that message number. Using all these three things, we can get the actual message, where it is located or where it is moved. Okay, and this consumer group, like multiple consumers from a group to share the workload. Generally, if you have the couple of consumers in this consumer group, and we have two partitions, each partitions can access its consumer and load the data into the destination in a very fast manner. Okay, so these are some of the basic terms which we use, and one more is that replication factor also we use. Replication factor is nothing but to make the copies of the data, copies of the same data, so that it handles in the fault tolerance. When we also know that Apache Kafka is a fault tolerant systems. So to maintain that fault tolerant systems, what it does is it whatever the number we give the replication factors, it creates so many samples there, copies of the same data, so that even any one of the broker goes down, the other brokers can pick it up and read the data. Okay, so even you'll be hearing this term too often. Okay, that's about replication factor. So these are some of the terms you often come across whenever you're dealing with Kafka, Apache Kafka. Okay, thank you for watching. Please do subscribe my YouTube channel.